Welcome to lectures on building materials. In today's lecture, we will learn about timber. In the previous lecture, we have already learned about the timber, what is natural, the seasoning of timber, in that we have two processes, the natural seasoning and artificial seasoning, we have already learned. In the artificial seasoning also, we have four processes, that is boiling process, skin seasoning process, chemical seasoning process, and then electrical seasoning process. This we have already learned. In the boiling, the timber is immersed into the water and it is boiled for a duration of 3 to 4 hours so that the sap can be removed. We will just revise this fast. And skin seasoning, it used to be a tight chamber where the temperature is used to be in between 35 to 38 degrees centigrade, and the heat gradually reaches inside the chamber and it tries to reduce the humidity. As the humidity reduces as the temperature increases. Then we have electrical seasoning. In this, the electric current passes from the timber. So as the electric current and we know that the water or the moisture is a good inductor of the current. So that as the current will pass, due to the heat will generate and due to that there will be a reduction in the moisture. So as there will be a reduction in the moisture, the timber will work as an insulator to current, and the resistance will increase. So that can be taken as a measure of degree of seasoning. Then we have the trigger conversion. So for today's lecture, we will start directly from here. What is tree conversion? The tree conversion is the trees are generally cut during the winter seasons, just because of the sap which accumulate on the timber during that season is very 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 less. In the monsoon time, the moisture content is used to be very high in the timber, so generally we avoid the cutting of tree during that time. So if you will go for the cutting of the tree during that time, then the accumulation of sap will be too high. So that's why generally the tree are preferred to cut during the winter season, so that the sap accumulation will be very less. After felling of trees, these trees are transported to the sawmills and they are cut into the number of boards. So this cutting of this tree is not, and the cutting of tree in the form of boards is called the tree conversion. Here we have the three methods for the tree conversion. One is through and through sawing, then we have tangential sawing, and then we have the quarter sawing. So let's concentrate on the through and through sawing. In the through and through sawing, what we do? And this is the most popular method of sawing one thing, that the logs are generally cut in the parallel direction of the grain. Suppose this is the cross section of the wooden, and this is the grain direction. Then if this is the grain direction, they are cut in the parallel direction of grain. So that means they will be cut directly in this way. Means suppose this is then we will make the parallel cuts, means like this. And through sawing, the cuts are made parallel to the grain direction. The cuts are made parallel to the direction of grain. We have certain advantages of this method. What are those? The first one is, it is cheaper method, the cost is very low, as well as it is a fast method, because directly we need to we just take it in the vertical direction, keep the log in the vertical direction and just directly cut parallel to the grain direction, so that the cutting, that is conversion, will be the very fast, as there will be time saving, time required will be less, so that it will be the low cost. The maximum width of the frame can be obtained from the log, while the cut which will be made from the center, that will give the maximum width of the plank. There will be little wastage because each and every plank can be utilized anywhere. It reveals attractive grain pattern, especially in the soft wood. As we have certain advantages, definitely it has certain limitations also. What are those? It is not suitable for the structural timber, one thing. Then With this method, the cupping caused by tangential shrinkage is a problem. Generally, as we cut due to the warping up and warping down, the wooden plank will try to warp up. Due to shrinking, this due to tangential cracking, it may the warp up. So that warp up, that this shrinking, as it will warp up, this the process of warping up of the wooden plank is known as the cupping. So there is generally as there will be cupping, that is a warping up of the plane, as there will be warping up, it will cause us the tensile stress at the bottom, fiber of the wood. It will further cause the shrinkage cracking at the bottom. Means this is suppose this is a plane. Due to warping up, this will try to turn up. Stress in the bottom portion, that will cause the tensile strain, and this further tensile strain will further cause the shrinkage crack in the bottom fiber, that is in on the outer bar. Then next we have the tangential sewing. In the tangential sewing, we generally draw the lines on the tangents, we generally draw lines, or to say we generally draw the tangents to the annual rings. What we are trying to do? These are the annual rings. On the annual rings, we have drawn the tangents. So these are the tangents. We have drawn the tangents. Once we got these tangents, then we make the cuttings of this wooden planks along these tangents. First of all, this is the outer tangent. What is the outermost tangent? First cut will be made corresponding to this. Once it will be cut down, after that this wooden plank will be turned to the 90 degree. So what we are doing, first of all we are cutting the wood from this side. Once this will be cut, this wooden plank will be turned to the 90 degree. So after turning to 90 degree, this portion will be facing ups. So this portion will come up. As we are turning it from this side to 90 degree, this portion will come up. After cut once, this portion will come up. We will cut this. We will cut this wooden block from this side. Once this will be cut down again, this wooden block will turn to 90 degree. Once it will be turned, then this face will come on the top or on the. This will be on upside. Then after that, this side will be cut down. Again, it will be rotated to 90 degree side, and then after that, this side will be up. Will be turn up. After that, this side will be cut down. So in tangential sewing, what we are doing, we are drawing the tangents on the annual rings, and then cutting is made corresponding to this tangent. After every cut, the wooden block is turned to the 90 degrees so that the cut can be made on the other side. There's the cutting is made in this pattern. It displays the kind of figure. This we can see in this figure. This is the cutting of this tangential sewing causes a flame kind of structure. It causes the flame structure. Again, we have certain advantages in this method and certain disadvantages. What are those? Let's first discuss the advantages. It produces the board with the flame figure. Tangential boards are strong boards, and they can be used for the beams and joists, which requires the higher strength of the timber. The hardwood and safewood can be easily separate out as we are drawing the tangent corresponding to annual rings, and we are cutting. Suppose these are, as we have drawn the tangent on every annual rings, so cutting is made from this. So what we are doing, we are cutting the wooden log, or to say the timber, from outer side to the inside side, from outer side to inside. This portion is called as hardwood, while this outer portion is called as the sapwood. So in this type of cutting, the sapwood and hardwood can be easily separated out. These boards can take a nail without splitting because of the position of their annual rings. Again, we have certain disadvantages in this. What are those? they are prone to shrinkage just because of the pain. It will again warp. As it will warp up, warp down, it will cause the tensile stress and tensile strain in the opposite fiber or into the bottom fiber. That will further result in the shrinkage, cracking. As we are drawn the tangents on the angle rings and the cuts are made corresponding to those tangents. After cutting, the wooden log need to be turned to 90 degree. As it requires so much labor as well as it is time consuming process, and hence it is the costlier one as compared to the through and through soil. Then we have the quarter soil. This method leaves the annual rings on the converted timber meeting the face of the board at 45 degree or more. And this what we are doing, generally this is the whole the wood, or to say this the cross section of this log or this timber. This is divided into four parts. We have, or that is the one, every part is called the quarter, 1/4 is called quarter. So we are making the four quarter on this side. This is 1/4, another quarter, third quarter, and this is fourth quarter. This is the first quarter, this is the second quarter, this is the third quarter, and this is the fourth quarter. So we have divided the log into the four number of quarters. Here we will drop a perpendicular from the outer bar till the annual rings. What we are doing here? Let me draw the annual rings. What we are doing from this outer bar? We are dropping a perpendicular and cut at some place. Then we will draw a horizontal line from this side like this, and again we will drop a perpendicular from this side, draw a horizontal line, and again this leaves like this. We are dropping a perpendicular from the outer bar. It cuts somewhere to angle rings. Just stop there and draw a horizontal line from there. So like this we are making the cuts. We are drawing some lines through which we will cut the log. So what we will do here again, we will make a cut from this side. Once this will be cut down, after that again it will be turned. After turning, we will cut it from this side. Then again we will turn it. After that we will cut it from this side. Again we will cut from this side, so that we will get the uniform thickness of the wooden plank. Again, it has certain advantages. What are those? An attractive grain pattern can be obtained from this method. Boards are more suitable and there will be less shrink. As we are not cutting it corresponding to, we are not cutting it parallel to the grain direction, as well as we are not going for the tangential sawing in this method. This is the quarter method. In this method, the shrinkage problem will be less as compared to the previous two. So this is one of the advantages, because if you are going for other type of conversion method, and that most of the time that leads to or that results in the shrinkage cracking of the timber. But this quarter sawing does not result most of the time in the shrinkage cracking. The boards wear more evenly and important for flooring purposes. But again, we have certain disadvantages, or to say the limitation in this. What are those? It is expensive, as the log has to be first quartered and then turned for every cut. Again, this is one of the problem in almost in every type of conversion method except the through and through sawing. Because the log is quartered, then cuts are made. The cuts becomes a narrower, and so the narrower boards are produced. We have certain properties for the good timber: color, odor, soundness, texture, grains, density, hardness, and warping. These are the properties of the good timber. It should be uniform in color. It should be pleasant while cutting. Soundness, a clear ringing sound. It must produce when stuck each other. That is one of the measure of its strength. And the texture, the texture of wood is should be fine and it should be even. Grains, in a good timber, the grains are very close. Density, it must possess the higher density. The hardness, the harder timbers are strong and durable. Warping, good timber do not trap under the changing environmental conditions. Then we have certain defects in the timber. What is the defects? The defects is nothing but it is the irregularity or the abnormality occurring in the wooden due to any reason. It causes certain problems in the timber. What are those? It causes the strength reduction, which further results in reduction in the durability. As the reduction in the durability, it causes the reduction in the lowering in utility, or to say that the reduction in utility. As the reduction in the utility, there will be decay. The decay is nothing but the reduction in the reduction in life, as well as there will be poor appearance. The classification of defects. The defects are classified into this certain ways. We have to study the defects due to the natural forces, defects due to the insects, defects due to the fungi, then defects due to the conversion, and defects due to the seasoning. These are the defects, these are the factors which causes the defects in the timber. First of all, let's see defects due to the natural forces. The natural forces, or to say the abnormal growth in the timber, causes these kind of defects. What are those? It causes the chemical strain, then the knots, then shakes, twisted fibers, rind balls, upsets and burn. The first one is the chemical strain. What is chemical strain? The chemical strain is nothing but certain kind of skin disease. What happens? The discolor in the wood, there will be change in the color of the wood due to some chemical actions. That is called the chemical strain. But the next one is the rind gall. What is the rind and gall? The rind means the bark, while the gall means the abnormal growth. So, what we can understand, what will be the meaning of rind galls? The abnormal growth in the bark of the tree, that will be called the rind gall problems. Where it happens generally? It develops at the places or at the points where the branches are cut down earlier. So, or they are removed. So, this kind of problem is rarely found in the tree, but if somewhere cuts are made earlier in the tree at that kind of places, the abnormal growth can be seen, then this kind of defects will be called the rind galls. Then we have the coarse grain. If the tree grows rapidly, the annual rings will be widened. If there will be reduction in the density of annual rings, that means the wood will be the hardness of the wood. Knots. What is the meaning of knots? They are the bases of branches or limbs which are broken or cut off from the tree. We can see these are nothing but the called as the knots. This portion from which the branch is removed receives some kind of nourishment from the stem, and this causes the tree again start growing in one way or other. That is called the knots. As the continuity of wood fibers are broken by knots from a source of weakness. Then we have the dead wood. The timber which is obtained from the dead wood, the timber which is obtained from the dead standing tree, of radish contains the dead wood. It is indicated as lightweight and the reddish color. As it is the red wood, we are getting this after felling down of almost the standing tree. The seasoning of this kind of tree will be completed just because of air circulation. So there will be almost the seasoning as the finest degree of the seasoning is obtained, and hence there will be lightweight in the there will be lightweight of the wood. Then the next defects, that is the shreds. What it is? These are the longitudinal separation in the wood between the annual rings. They are the cracks which partly or completely separates the fiber of wood. The separation makes the wood undesirable when appearance is important. Types of shakes. We have the four types of shakes. One is star shakes, cup shakes, then we have the heart shake, and then the last one is ring shakes. So we will start first of all with the star shakes. In the star shakes, what happens? The cracks start extending from the outer block to the heart of the timber, or towards the scaphoid of the timber. Generally, these cracks will be wider at the outer part, and they will be narrower towards the inside side. These generally happens due to extreme change in the temperature, either the extreme increase in the temperature during summer time or due to the frost action during the winter season, which causes, due to the extreme change in the temperature, this causes the shrinkage cracks. It causes shrinkage in the timber. Just because of that, these cracks develop and they start extending from the outer bark toward the sap. That is called the star shape. The next one is cup shape. The cup shape generally splits the old timber from the generally separates the timber along the annual rings. We can see here the other ring, it will split the timber along these rings. So this portion will be separated out from this portion. This is called the cup shapes. Then we have the heart shake. In the heart shake, the cracks start developing from the pith of the timber towards the outer bark. They generally used to be four cracks in a timber. While this is the ring shake, when the cup shakes covers the entire area, it will be called the ring shake. This was the cup shake. Suppose this is one of the ring. If this will occupy the whole this area, then this will be called the ring shakes. Then the next one is twisted fiber. These twisted fiber are known as the wandering heart, and the these are caused generally in the young tree or new tree, which are not that much stronger, and due to the fast blowing wind is try to take them towards the direction of wind, and they are not that much stronger to resist the force caused into the fast blowing wind. And just because of this, the fiber of these trees get twisted, and this defect is called the twisted fibers. Then we have the next, that is the upsets. These indicate the wood fiber which are injured by crushing or the compression. These upsets are mainly due to the improper threading of the tree and the exposure of tree in the young as of the fast blowing wind. Then the defects due to the fungi. These are the defects which are caused due to the fungi, that is the blue stem. Then we have the brown rot. Then we have the dry rot, the hard rot, wet rot, and the white rot. These are the defects which are caused due to fungi. Defects due to the insects. These are the insects which causes the defects. There is beetle, then we have the marine borers, then we have the termites. Defects caused due to beetles. They form a pinholes of about 2 mm diameter in the wood. Here we can see. What they are doing, they are forming a pin size holes of size of about 2 mm in diameter in the wood. They generally form, the tunnel formation is done in the step wood by the larva of the beetle. The conversion of timber into the flow-like powder. It generally enters into the timber and then they start eating the timber and they make almost the powder kind of flow-like powder. They do not generally disturb the outer shell or cover. They directly affect on the hardwood of the timber. Defects due to the marine borers. They are found generally in salty water. They form the tunnel or bores to take their shelters. Here we can see their pores are trying to form the tunnels. The diameter and the length of the holes are as high as 25 mm to the 60 mm. It used to be in the range of this. They are affected. The affected wood loses its color and strength. These are the defects caused by the termites. They generally live in the colony and very fast in eating away from the wood from the core of cross section. They make the tunnel in the different direction and usually not disturb the outer shell of the cotton cover. The only the few types of timbers cannot be affected by these, like teak and sal, and they can resist the effects of termites. Then these are the effects which are caused due to the conversion, like chip marking, then diagonal grain, torn grain, and the grain. These are the defects which are caused due to the conversion. So this is all about the timber. In the timber we have discussed till now the different about this timber, different terminology in the timber, then the types of seasoning, artificial seasoning, the natural seasoning, then we have gone for the conversion, different types of conversion, through and through conversion, tangential conversion, then water conversion, then we have seen the properties, what is the characteristic of the timber, then we have seen the various defects in timber. Thank you.